really enjoys being around people. He enjoys interacting with people, which is something that a lot of autistic people don't have. He has this ability to make people really like him, even though sometimes he does things they don't like. Yeah, so his personality is one of his greatest strengths. As soon as someone hears those diagnoses, they just shut off. They don't want to know, you know. And then people make assumptions. And professionals make assumptions about Jack because of those diagnoses, about what he's capable of, and how he should be treated, how he should be interacted with because of those diagnoses. And sometimes I think that really puts a limit on him. We relinquished Jack when he was 12, and the main impetus for that was twofold. My mental health, which was quite poor, and the lack of services, lack of support. Since the age of 8, there was not a service in Toowoomba that would take Jack for respite because of his behaviours. So it became extremely difficult. That was the hardest decision we've ever had to make. We did what we thought was best for Jack and the rest of the family. We had very little family support.
Gar love.
He was all a bit too hard. very few friends. Most of our friends just sort of disappeared. When it comes to services, government, very, very little. Very little. We're working with a speech therapist who is employed by the service that looks after Jack. But we get to see her once every 6 to 9 months. It just doesn't work. It just doesn't work. And that's one of the most frustrating things. Because as you can see, he's quite vocal. But it's really struggles to communicate anything but his very basic needs. He can tell you that he wants something to eat. He can tell you to go away. You know, mummy bye-bye or whatever. But if he's in pain, if something's going on for him, he can't tell you. And that's one of the biggest problems that we face. Mm. Well, the only medical people we have at the moment is a GP, and he's great. He's actually really, really good. Jack started seeing him when he was still with the department. And when Jack was too upset to go to see him, the doctor would actually go to Jack's place, which I think is pretty rare these days. Luckily, Jack is a very strong, healthy young man, which is good because, again, with the communication problems, if something's going on for him physically, it's very, very difficult to find that out. Very, very difficult. Glove. His main issues are bowel issues, which he's had all his life, and there's a lot of a lot of dispute around whether that's a medical issue or a behavioural issue.
Sort of long term, I can see him maybe having, with help of course, you know, he might have his own little business somehow, you know, we're still working on that yet, but working on the mowing and that sort of thing, developing up, and I'm sort of hoping maybe down the track he might be able to even help me if I work for myself later on down the track. You'd only have to show him once, I think, what sort of do. I think you'd always have to be there to supervise, but he could do the work, I think, you know.
He needs support, he needs prompting and supervision, but he can do it. He can clean himself, he can do his washing, he can sweep the floor, he can make his tea. So what we need is people to help him to explore his world. That's what we need. We need people who will go out into the world with Jack and explore so we can find out what it is that Jack likes to do, what Jack wants to do, and what he's good at.